I'm out here working on bow drill fire number 3. We had some rain last night. Got a crazy dog here. So I was kind of concerned about the tinder I would use for this fire. Of course, around here it's interbark cottonwood. So that's the best thing to use naturally. So I'm in a pretty big cottonwood tree. A lot of canopy above me. There's a piece of down wood right here. It's got some amazing inner bark hanging off there. It looks pretty dry. I think that'll work for today's fire. So tonight's fire, I guess, is going to be started with elm. Got this dead standing little tree here, part of a live tree, but this branch that's coming off here is dead. It's in the ground. It's off the ground, it's in the air. So even though it rained last night, it's under good canopy. I'm pretty sure it's going to be dry enough to use for a bow drill set. I'll make my hearth and my bearing block out of this piece here. And then I'll find something for a spindle. Probably that piece right there doesn't look too bad. Or even out here. So, guess I will get to cutting. Okay, I earned these ones. There's my bearing block, spindle, hearth board, my worn out old saw from Kmart, I don't know, Circle K, I don't know. I got a Baco left lander in my backpack in the truck. All right, let's go find us a bow for the bow part of this bow drill kit. So I found me a little stick here for the bow. Got a nice notch in the top. It's got a nice little integrated handle. Yeah, just about right. All right, so there's tonight's fire kit. Made from elm, except for the inner bark, of course, of the cottonwood tree. For the tender bundle. Some assembly required. So let's go start assembling. All right, so I found me a workbench. Like having a workbench saves your knees and saves you from getting cut as bad. I'm going to see if I can start batoning this. I don't want to tear into it with this knife. That's what I got tonight. I do have a good crack in this piece of elm here, but this is elm. Whew, that's tough. I'm going to have to cut some wedges or something. Then again, this is an LT Ride Genesis. So I'm cutting me some wedges here, see if I can save my knife a little bit. I'm gonna get this bow drill set made. I'm gonna be too tired to bow. There we go, huh? That might work.
$100 wedge kit. We'll go with that one right there, huh? It's not exactly flat. Getting to work on my spindle here. It's gonna take a while to get this elm whittled down. I hope it's not too green. It might be a bit green. Sure isn't cutting like it's green, but. Hard one for last, didn't I? Guarantee you a beaver could have done a better job than I did with this. It's a little big for a spindle, but we'll see if it works. There we go. Big worn out eraser on one end and a sharp pencil on the other. Sharp-ish. Big old spindle, ain't it? All right, now what's going to be the hard part here? Let's see. This one, I think, huh? Right there. If I can make a divot in that dude. I should just use this. the workbench out in the field because you got something to brace up against. Keep from slipping as bad. That was a skunk finder. Kind of a goofy looking bow. That's all right, it'll work. Little Johnny. Thank you. Okay. Got my bearing block all straightened out here. Okay, we may be ready for a burn-in. Okay, I think we might be ready for a burn-in. Let's see what happens. Let's get set up for that. Be regretting this using this little bow here on the dang elmwood set. I don't know, we'll see what happens. Anybody else use bank line for the bow? Well, I sure like it. Ooh, I sure like using it. Even better than paracord. A little bit of dust, a little bit of smoke. Got a little spot on the top there that's not getting any heat. Someone went ahead and notched that with the saw. Not a very pretty notch. Not the prettiest notch I ever made, but I think it'll work. People ask me my favorite way of starting a fire. I tell them a road flare and a gallon of diesel. Isn't that just amazing? Look at that. That's just amazing. A little bit wet, I better put down something. Primo. See that all right? Little bird's nest. See if it's dry enough to go. See if we can get a cold over here. All right. See what happens. If I can have success with an elm bow drill kit. It'll be the first time I do. Thank you. still didn't get it. Oh man, that's too bad. Thought I had it on that one. Nothing. Darn, thought we had that one. I think my spindle's too big. And it's elm. Alright, I'm gonna try a little bit smaller. Spindle. This may be a burn-in, I don't know, we'll see what happens here. Still no. Oh, wait. Wait a minute there. Whoa, there we go. Look at that. Yeah, buddy. Look at that, huh? You see that? Yes, sir. Not much of one, but it's an ember. There we go. All right. There we go. Yes, indeed. Woo. Very cool. All right. Had to work for that one a little bit, didn't we? Oh man. Well, there we go. That was fun. That took a while. Good grief. Glad it wasn't raining or wind wasn't blowing or it was cold or the family was hungry or something. Well, that was cool. That's bow drill fire number 3. I used cottonwood, willow, and then elm tonight. Elm was the full set, except for the tender bundle was made out of the inner bark from a cottonwood tree. I had to cut 2 spindles because the first one was too big around. I made the smaller one here. And shoot, it took right off, no problem. All right, thanks for sticking around. Hope you enjoyed that.